Sakshi Malik of India will take on Aysulu Tinimbekova of Kyrgyzstan. It's the bronze medal in the 58 kilogram weight category. That is Sakshi Malik's route. And she has had to work very, very hard for this indeed. Work hard for it she has. Tinbekova. The losing semi-finalist. Out they go, onto the mat. Bronze medal is the reward. Malik, who has had success in the Commonwealth Games, silver medalist. Roman Pavlov from Ukraine is the referee. Currently sixth in the world. Moment here for Malik to really take in the scale of this opportunity for her. Who will seize it? India in the red, Kyrgyzstan in the blue. The attempt to find the position there. This freestyle wrestling bout, 2 3-minute periods. It's the maximum the contest can go on for, as Malik just concedes the position and just briefly drop down to the mat. Second Olympic appearance for Tinbekova, and there's an opportunity here for Malik to capitalise. She's trying to convert this into something. Got a hold of the leg here. She'll try to rotate around. But equally, this could be a stalemate. And so back up into the standing position. Get a sense of each other here.
Yeah, Malik's been impressive right through the day. She's come back from deficits in more than one bout. She's tough and she's very fit and strong. It's going to be a really terrific battle, this one.
And I think that's the danger, and something that surely Tinbekova will know when facing Malik, is that if she doesn't have a healthy lead approaching the final seconds of the bout, it could well go away from her. Malik is a wrestler who's capable of getting the big 4-point score, the big takedown. She's got the strength to do that. And she's also somebody who's brave enough to go for it as well. But all that to one side for now, what she's got to do is to worry about the 30-second passivity call. So needs to attack here. She's at her best when she's in this attacking position.
It's like when her back's to the wall, she really fires up and has got the ability to really send her opponent backwards onto their heels.
But on this occasion, nothing doing. So the first score is registered to the wrestler in blue. And it's going to be a single point for Aysulu Tinbekova of Kyrgyzstan, who leads by one. Goes for the leg, that's really nicely done. So quick there, out of bounds goes Malik, but it's still going to be 2 points. Got that fast.
Well, Malik actually avoided what could have been a potentially worse situation there. She tried to use the zone outside the wrestling area as her friend there, and could have gone really pear-shaped for her there on that occasion. So to concede the 2 points, it's probably about the best job she could have done in that situation.
How fast Tinbekova moved. Got around so quickly to get the leg. Something that Malik is going to have to be particularly vigilant for as we approach the end of the first period. And again, she goes for it. And that's going to be another score there. It will just be... Oh, no, it is the two. It's the full 2 points.
Well, Tinya Bekova is so fast. She's so quick. And Malik is... There's a few alarm bells ringing in the Indian camp right now.
Second time she's just dashed around fast, got the leg, got the takedown. Almost a mirror image, really. Well, there we go. Reach the halfway point. And the advantage at the moment is a compelling one. It's not a good picture for Sakshi Malik. She's got a lot of work to do here in this second period. But as you say, she is a wrestler who can overcome deficits. Well, this is a deficit.
Yes, it is a big one, and this opponent is very classy. Because showed admirable fighting qualities. A lot of ticker, as they say. Never give up attitude. And she's going to have to show it all again here if she wants to get a bronze medal.
Second period gets underway. 58 kilogram bronze medal bout. And Malik, who has looked so good and so determined throughout all of her bouts, has got a massive challenge. Again, going for the leg. This time, Malik is quick to defend it. And she's going to try to convert this into an attacking position here. Something different there from Malik, but she's got a problem here. Timbakova with the potential lift as they battle for position here. Which way this one's going to go? Malik now with marginal position. No, round they go again. And the referee is about to call that one a stalemate. So it was hard to see any advantage there. But something different there from Malik in terms of the defence.
Was, yes, and that was a near thing for both wrestlers. I think both of them, even though they would have liked to have finished that off, were well aware that they could have easily been the victim of a big score against them there. Probably both relieved to start again. Malika still 4 points, 5 points down.
2 minutes, not long. A lot of points, and again going for the leg, but Malik is watching that leg defense, and she's managed to channel that into a score of 2 points. So some real differences we're noticing here in Malik, and she's trying to turn her over here, got onto her back. That's going to be another couple of points, and just held it for a moment into something approaching a pin position. Have to sustain it for longer than that, but got her into the danger position. So the deficit now just one, and this is Malik fighting back in the way that she's done all through the day.
It's extraordinary what Malik is able to do. I mean, a 5 point deficit for a bronze medal is going to be some deficit to overhaul, and she's now within a whisker of it.
Well, there was some good reflection, some good coaching that went on in that 30 seconds. A lot can be achieved during that time because she's changed the way that she's treating when Timbakova goes for the leg. Still trails, though, into the last minute. Asulu Timbakova is doing enough at the moment by virtue of picking up five very key points early on in the bout.
Got to be wary not to get too defensive here, the Kyrgyzstan wrestler. I think she might be the sounder strategy with Malik coming home strong again.
And going for it big here, but not quite able to convert. Last 30 seconds of the contest.
Well, could this one be decided in the last few seconds again?
It does have a habit of going that way, wrestling. She's going for the big takedown, but that time the defense from Timbakova, who's going to try and rotate this round and score something of her own here, and that would put pay to it all. It might just be enough here, but Malik going for it. Has she got something there? She's got... Now, she's got a single point there, but as we look at the scoreboard, that would put Timbukova ahead by virtue of having got a four-point score. The way that would position things is Malik is going for it in the last few seconds here. Can she manage to get something here? And she's got it! She's got 2 points right at the very end! Sakshi Malik has just taken the bronze medal in the last seconds of the bout.
Well, there is a challenge, but as we often see from the coaches, it's just a desperation move. Malik, outstanding. Come back again.
Well, Timbukova had that one on the separation criteria, and just as we were working that one through, suddenly Malik was busy working something through of her own. So let's just pause for a moment's reflection as the mat chair and team pause for their reflection. Confirmation there that the challenge is going to be a successful challenge, and it is an extra point added for the failed challenge. That is a bronze medal to India. It's a bronze medal to Sakshi Malik. The 2 points stands, the extra point added. She has taken the bronze right at the end. It's characteristic of how she's done everything throughout the day's wrestling.
Oh, well, well, the Pakistan wrestler not happy with that call whatsoever. Gee, defeat is hard to take in the wrestling.
Sakshi Malik is absolutely jubilant. She cannot believe that she's won that right at the very end. It should not in so many ways come as a surprise, because it is characteristic of how she has battled all throughout this day's wrestling program. And she takes home a bronze medal. Just extraordinary. What about? What a contest. What a bronze medal.
Médaillé de bronze, représentant l'Inde.
Bronze medalist, representing India.
Médaille de bronze, représentant l'Inde.
Sakshi Malik.
Throughout the whole day of wrestling, she kept fighting right until the very end. Kept fighting, wrestling hard, and got the job done. 5 points down in her bronze medal bout. She somehow found a way to come back and take the bronze, the first Olympic women's wrestling medal for India. And what a worthy recipient of the honour. The bronze medal in the 58 kilogram category going to Sakshi Malik of India. Well, she is overcome with emotion. She has dominated African wrestling, 8 times the African champion. A massive 4-point score at the end of her bronze medal bout. To triumph, she struck the mat with joy to secure the first medal in wrestling ever for Tunisia. That's at Olympic or World Championship level. This an enormous moment for Tunisia, and huge for bronze medalist Marwa Amri.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Olympic medalist at 58 kilos in women's freestyle wrestling.
Senhoras e senhores, essas são as campeãs da categoria. 58 quilos feminino, as medalhistas olímpicas.